So we will now look at what is a vector joining two points. So I have two points here, as you can see in the diagram. The first point is your A, the second point is your B, right? So what are the coordinates of A? A's coordinates are x1. Let me just use a different color here. A's coordinates are x1, y1 and z1, right? x1, y1, z1. And you guys already know what these three terms, you know, they mean and why they're separated by a comma. And this is x2, y2 and z2, right? So this is actually the coordinates of these two points. Now, you want the vector which starts from A and goes to B, right? You want a vector which starts from A and goes to B. That means you need this vector. That means you need this vector AB bar, right? AB bar, the one which starts from A and goes to B, right? So let me just draw that here. This is your A, x1, y1, z1, and this is your B, x2, y2, z2. And you need that vector which starts from here and goes here, right? Let's actually derive how to actually get this vector, right? So this is a vector. This obviously, just like every other vector, you know, this is a three-dimensional space, right? This is a 3D space. So just like every other three-dimensional space, and you take, for example, any vector, this vector has some I component, you know, plus some J component. We have already seen what components are, plus some K component, right? I component, J component, K component. They can be zero or non-zero, doesn't matter, but I can represent a vector in this. So this is also a vector. This AB bar that you see is also a vector. Now, how do I represent this vector in this form? How do I represent this vector in some I cap, J cap, K cap form? We've already seen that. We've already seen components of a vector. You can go back and refer to that. You know, that's the knowledge that will be useful here. So for that, what we'll do is we'll first have to derive. So if you look at this green vector here in this white image, this is your AB bar, right? This vector is your AB bar. Now, if I start from here, if I start from the origin and go to this vector OA, then I will have OA bar, right? This is your OA bar because it's starting from origin and going to A, so it's OA bar. And this is your second vector, AB bar. Take a third vector which starts from B and goes to the origin. So your third vector starts from B and goes to the origin. So what is this vector? This vector is BO bar, right? Because it starts from B and goes to the origin, right? This is OA bar plus BO bar plus AB bar. Can someone tell me what will the result be? Yes, this will be a zero. This will be a zero. Why? According to the triangle's law. As you can see, this vector here, and this vector here, they form a closed triangle, right? So the third one is this vector. They form a closed triangle. So they have, their vectorial sum has to be zero, zero bar, right? That means if I need AB bar is nothing but BO bar negative minus OA bar. And BO bar negative can be written as OB bar, right? This can be written as OB bar minus OA bar, right? So if I have a vector AB bar, and if I want its, you know, negative, then, you know, it, I can also write it like this, minus of minus BA bar, right? So in fact, sorry, it's minus of BA bar, because BA bar is minus AB bar. So like that minus and this minus, they'll be plus, right? They'll multiply it to be plus. So if you reverse the order of these two terms, these two alphabets in your vector, you'll have to account a negative sign, right? That is what I've done here. So AB bar is equal to OB bar minus OA bar is your final result. Now the question is, what is OB bar? The question is, what is OB bar? So OB bar is simple. OB bar is the position vector of this point B, right? Let me just erase. And now that we already have got the result that we need. So can someone tell me, what is the position vector of a point? If a point has coordinates x, y, z, What do I mean by the position vector? The vector which starts from the origin and goes to that point is the position vector, right? And how is that vector represented as if the coordinates are x, y, z, then x, y, y, j and z, k is the position vector of this point, right? That means what is your OB bar? Your OB bar is x2 I plus y2 j plus z2 k, right? That's what the position vector is. Now, what is OA bar? OA bar is the position vector of this point A, because this is the vector which starts from the origin and goes to this point A. So what is your vector OA bar? OA bar is nothing but x1i plus y1j plus z1k. Now, what you need is AB bar, which is the difference of these two, the difference of these two. So it is OB bar minus OA bar, that means it is x2 minus x1, or in fact, let me just not write it directly, if some of you might just get confused. So this is x2i plus y2j plus z2k minus x1i plus, you can always write it like this, put a bracket x1i plus y1j plus z1k. Now, this is the difference of two vectors and their component forms. We've already seen the component form, right? What do we have to do? We have to take the components which are present along the same direction and subtract them. So this x1, this x2 and x1, they are along I, right? This is the magnitude along I. Along I means along x-axis. So I can straight away subtract them. Your AB bar is x2 minus x1i. Similarly, it will be y2 minus y1j plus z2 minus z1k, right? That's what your final vector is. This means if I have two points A and B, and if I need the position vector from A to B, so remember, if I need the position vector from A to B, then what I'll do is I'll take the coordinates of B first, and then I will subtract the coordinates of A from the coordinates of B, right? I'll subtract x1 from x2. So I'll take the coordinate of B first, then I'll subtract the coordinate of A, and this is along the I direction, so I'll put an I. I'll take the coordinate of, you know, J direction coordinates, first B, then A, then put a J, right? And then finally, Z of B, then Z of A, and then put a K, right? So what you have to do is just subtract the coordinates of both the points and then put I, J, K, like put an I, put a J and put a K along the corresponding differences, right? And what you have to take, if you're going from A to B, then you will take B first and then A. What if you're going from A to B to A? If you were going from B to A, then you will take A first, right? So you will do X1 minus X2I plus y1 minus y2j plus z1 minus z2k. So I hope you have been able to, you know, make the difference of what is to be done. And with this, we complete the topic called vector joining two points. That's how you find the vector joining two points. If you know their coordinates, just subtract. Make sure you do it in the correct order. If you're going from A to B, then you take B first and then A. Make sure you follow this order. Subtract, put an I. Subtract, put a J, subtract the coordinates and put a K, right? And that's your vector. So with this, we complete this topic, vector joining two points. Let's move on to the next subtopic.